Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for the Commodore Amiga. Let's rest. Awesome. Now we'll be better prepared for what awaits us. Who needs... Well, nobody needs anything, that's right. Because we rested. Never mind. Go fight those mutants. You guys saw this before. Alright, so same as last time. I'm gonna gather back there. He's using a knife, so I'm just gonna have him come up here. I don't see any use in trying to improve his skill anymore, because... Or his speed, rather. I mean, you can, but it's off the charts. He has unlimited movement now. Alright, so we're attacking. Yeah, Varanus can't move. Yeah, I don't want him to be too close. More speed, that's always good. But I want him to be able to reach with that. He's got the grenade. Or grenade launcher. First blood goes to Epsilon. That he silently blows a missile from his blowpipe or something? Corall throws a radium grenade. Oh, it is affecting stamina. Actually, I don't like him grouped together like that. He's gonna keep throwing those grenades. How do you miss with a grenade? Becomes very intense. Okay, so far. Good thing he can attack a lot of times. 10% strength due to his close combat experience. Well, some of these guys are terrible shots, really. I gotta start moving more people out. Oh yeah, can I do that? It's a tunnel, right? Of life force drain. If he was sitting up here or down there, he could hit both of them. But he's not. He's dead. Kinda have to clear away the way for people, though. Not that we did that. 8 vitality. Alright, okay. Threw me how he was facing the other way. Nice, huh? You like that? Hopefully that's not too close. I want to clear the way for people to get past. Because he can't get past, though. Anyone need help with stuff? I mean, soon. Right now, we're okay. Otherwise, I was going to throw some Alpha Catharsis out there. I'm trying to line it up for the life force drain here. He's hitting his own people. Interesting sound with it, though. Take that, Corall. Stupid name. Sorry, you're actually possessed. Hey, it wasn't very nice to begin with, though. Trying to avoid this. Everyone getting hit by grenades. I'll be hitting Varanus now. Someone right in front of you. He didn't want to. He was already prepared for a range attack, that's why. Looking forward to that tunnel. Hope these guys don't move. The tunnel of life force drain, that is. Oh, well, this guy's gonna be dead. Oh, not yet then. An advent. It's very widespread. Hopefully his own people die before we do. I got him. Can you reach that far? No, you can't. Alright, we're gonna get ready to start healing people. Oops. Would include healing yourself, eventually. Probably Varanus neck first. Can you hit this guy? Because I'm kind of focusing. Yeah. Get him. Yay. So I can confirm the battles are getting easier, probably because of all these skill increases we get during combat. Where is this guy? He's there, okay. Now this is Twin Snake, who I feel never gets to go because he's so slow. Ugh. Really? You can hit the big boss man next. Two of us this time. His stamina's starting to get low. Oh, he's got the grenade. I don't want to hit Epsilon over there. Ah! As it is, hit himself. He's still alright. He's down to half. Are the weapons empty? Okay, we have ammo for that. I want to find ammo for our old guns, like our standard guns. We got splinter grenades, too. Well, let's use one of these. The weapon is loaded. Life force drain. Ugh. So disappointing. Okay, who... Which one is... He has the nunchuck hanging down. Oh, you can't reach him, can you? Line of sight shouldn't apply to healing spells. You cannot move. Your speed is extremely low. Oh, his speed is zero. Oh, crap. Is that from the grenades? Does it affect our speed? No one else's speed is like that. Everyone else's speed is fine. Well, Varanus is gonna have to get this. He can't move. That is weird. Maybe it's just a random effect of the radiation. Radian bomb, whatever it's called. Alright, so you. Maybe you can start to cast this spell then. Maybe that might be. Okay. Gotta get him away from the battle, anyway. It brandishes his wicked trident and attacks. So it says, I'll brandish this and attack. And we both missed, okay. Let's see if we miss this time, miscreant. Didn't miss this time. Advent? Well, that's true. Advent can cast it on himself. We're doing... Tunnel of Life Force Drain. Nice. Oh, I think his vitality's zero. Yay. Now with your leader gone, you should lose morale. That's not gonna happen. Not enough mit. I had a feeling. We made it. We can't move, so we're gonna do that. And we're gonna immediately save. What are we... I'm not sure what we're up to. 32, I think? I don't want to click outside the window to check my folders, and sometimes the game decides to not cooperate anymore. Okay, so we've all regained condition. What about his speed? Okay. I'm not sure. I guess it's an effect of the radion grenade, radion bomb, whatever. Oh, we've got stuff. His loot. backstabber knife. Well, that suits him, I think. Can I analyze it? Oh. That's right, I don't know why it does that. First we have to take it. Alright, so I'm going to assume it's something that Epsilon can use. We don't even use this stuff, the throwing stars. Okay, can we look at it now? Let's look at the old knife first. So we're actually looting the bodies. That's interesting. Alright. So I want the knight to use it. So the wounding is 14. Range 2. Physical attack is 25%. And I thought I was stuck again. Knight cannot use. Oh, and it's the same. 14-2. It requires 40 speed. We're all above that, right? Twin Snake might not be. 40 speed. Physical attack is plus 60%, though. Who can use it again? I just was focused on not Knight, which is him. Alright, I think, yeah, I'm gonna give this to... Yeah, Psionic, Anchorite. My Mercenary and Assassin are good. Psionic and Anchorite. Because, what's his name? Advent's almost out of his crossbow bolts. Or crossbow, whatever. Arrows. Oh. I think it's a crossbow that he has. Yeah, only has one ammo. So, give that to him. Yeah, there we go. Just out of curiosity. That said, it requires 40, so he obviously has higher than 40. Does anyone have horrible speed like that? No, even Twin Snake is 68. Yeah, we're good. Alright, so that's something to switch to when he runs out of ammo for that thing. Good to know. And I know I just saved, and I'm going to save again because... Who wants to do that all over again? Let's see if there's anyone else to talk to before we leave here. Whoops. Oh! Suddenly, Pearlblood drags you into a shadowy corner and excitedly gabbers with tears. Gobbers? Gabbers? With tears in her eyes. Oh no, the unborn. It killed my father just a few minutes after you have left him. Oh, there was a sea of blood. Now hurry. Oh, they killed her father. I'm going to lead you out of the mine before my people discover you here. I owe you this because I will never forget what you have done for me and my son. I know that I must help you to destroy that thing for my father and for this world. That's awfully nice of you. And now we're back here. What if I run back in? Is that a a bad thing. There's an ill-smelling pool of dirty, disgusting water. This is where we go attacked by those mutants when we first came in here. And I thought they were in this alcove, this one here, I'm trying to get over to, because they hit me in there, so I figured they were sitting in there. But no, they'll randomly attack you. Although, no one's showing up now. Okay. Do you really wish to leave this area? Yes. Map. Okay. So it's not the neon temple yet? I forget what it's called. Oh, no, no. Nothing but death and pain remained here. You better do not go back to this cursed, desperate place. Oh, abort. You're facing the silent, gaping entrance of the Soul Tomb Mines. Alright. Oh, right. For some reason you can't use the directional keys on the map. You have to click this stuff. Small cave entrance. So when do we go in there? Ever? The situation in the city became totally uncontrolled. The riot is raging in the streets, so you decide it's better not to interfere and take any senseless risks. I do, huh? You're staring down into a frightening abyss. I just want to see what it says here. Hey, it would really be a lot of wasted time to visit the colony once again. You have nothing left to do here. Go and continue your mission instead. Exclamation point. Alright, so I forget the name of this place. What's this? Near the Sandstorm Citadel. Towers. Well, I bet at the moment you cannot say one single acceptable reason to go in there. So maybe it's here that we're supposed to go, across this water? Once I see the name, I'll be reminded. Eastern side, yeah, there's nothing. Alright. So we have to cross somehow. We have to go up, and then... it just goes back up there. Oh god. No. across the bridge. You're on the ancient bridge over the Molten Down. Eastern Crossroad. Wait a second. Yeah. You're approaching a quite strange and strong-looking construction. After hiding your sand glider ship among the dunes, you have to force yourself with each step to concentrate on your quest for the Guardian, instead of being frustrated by your own imagination, which tells you that you are just about to walk straight into the lion's throat. Your uneasy feeling grows as you're getting closer and closer to this dark stronghold called Fort Nightfall. Well, not a really inviting name, but it suits perfectly to Lord Daleth, the owner of this fortress, as you remember him from the criminal records you have studied during your preparations in the Sandstorm Citadel. Besides that, he's a very dangerous murderer and drug smuggler. He also is one of the most powerful mediators of the Empire. He's a high priest of Carnivore, an insane, extremely evil entity from the Twilight Continuum. Rumors tell about perverse ceremonies and horrible experiments behind these dark walls, deep down in the catacombs. The music's amazing. Wow. Okay. So, that'll be next time. Next episode, guys, we'll be exploring this. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.